Are there any du'as or supplications that the Prophet ﷺ specifically made in Hajj? The Prophet ﷺ said in a beautiful hadith that the tawaf, the circling around the Kaaba, and the sa'i, the passing between the mountains of Safa and Marwa, and the rest of the Hajj have been made in order for one thing and one thing only, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So yes, the entire Hajj is filled with remembrances of the Prophet ﷺ, of Allah Azza wa Jal, and particular du'as that he would make. And among those are the very famous du'a that we were all taught, and that is when the Prophet ﷺ was making tawaf, circulating around the Kaaba. And when he reached the door of the Kaaba, before that there's a pillar of the Kaaba, or a corner called the corner of Yemen, the Yemeni corner. And until the black stone, this wall is called the Yemeni wall. Why? Because it faces Yemen. And in this period, the Prophet ﷺ would say the dua, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. That, oh, our Lord, grant us from this world what is good, and grant us from the hereafter what is good, and save us from the punishment of the fire. And the Prophet ﷺ made this dua because it literally encompasses all good that you can, materially, or what is in the hereafter, as well as preventing you from harm. As well as, the Prophet ﷺ made one of the most powerful du'as on the same mountain which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to proclaim the message of Islam, and that is the mountain of Safa. And that mountain, he makes a du'a which we all say, and that is, that he said, La ilaha illallah wahda, there is no God except Allah alone. Nasara abda, he gave victory to his servant. Wa anjaza wa'da, and he fulfilled his promise. Wa hazama al-ahzaba wahda, and he took care of all of his enemies and the obstacles in his life alone. The Prophet ﷺ came to that mountain when he went on his farewell pilgrimage. And the most beautiful and powerful moment in the life of the Prophet ﷺ is on that farewell pilgrimage, there was over 120,000 companions looking at the Prophet ﷺ with love and wanting to hear what he has to say so they can implement it. Whereas, literally about 20 years prior to that, 22 years prior to that, the Prophet ﷺ was on the same mountain. And when he made the call to Islam, he was rejected on that same mountain. So he made that dua as if to say, oh Allah, it is because of you and your fulfilling of your promise. You gave victory to me and you helped me to overcome all of the obstacles in my path. You, when you go to Hajj and Umrah, make that same dua to say, oh Allah, you're the only one who will fulfill my promises. And you're the only one who can give victory to me personally. And you're the only one who can help me overcome my own obstacles, my own difficulties, and take care of my own enemies. And these are some of the most beautiful du'as that the Prophet ﷺ made in Hajj.